Procrastination, a recipe for success. It is, of course, by me, Ryan Thomason-Jones. And basically, I'm going to teach you, like this man here, how to gain a big W and basically succeed when procrastinating. Who am I and why should you care about what I'm about to say? I am a 3D environment artist. I've been working in the industry for about 2 years at this point, just over. I've been working at some companies, as you can see on my shirt. That's just one company, but I've been at a few. 95% of that was spent working from home, so I feel like if I can talk about anything, it's working at home. I'm currently working on an unannounced title. And I am also, as most of you know, a chef. Questions. After this presentation, you're bound to at least question life, so please feel free to type them in Expo Q&A. And partly the reason that this presentation took so long is that I was procrastinating making this video for you all. So I hope you enjoy this short film. I will say there are some scenes that people may find unsettling. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked that story about a piece of bread cheating on me. This is what procrastination does, people. This is why you need to learn about procrastination and why it's ruining your work life. Now, let's go through the topics we are going to cover. We'll go through the basics. What is procrastination? Who of you is more likely to procrastinate? And how does procrastination impact us? Then we'll talk about working from home, how to avoid procrastinating at home, what to do if you find yourself procrastinating, and how can you optimize your environment for productivity. And we'll have tools and takeaways, quite literally. First off, the basics. And the first thing you should know is Gordon Ramsay said my food is delicious. So if you all come in here saying my food looks like shit, I literally have the big G saying it looks incredible. So Anyway. What is procrastination? Procrastination is the habit of delaying an important task, usually by focusing on less urgent, more enjoyable, and easier tasks instead. It is different from laziness, which is the unwillingness to act. Procrastination can restrict your potential and undermine your career. AKA, it's not very epic. Procrastination sucks. Who is more likely to procrastinate? Conditions such as ADHD may be a root cause as to why you are procrastinating. If this is something you believe may affect you, fill in a self-assessment form regarding ADHD and have a discussion with your doctor. Note, depending on where you live, this can be a long and disheartening process, but hang on in there. Also, literally anyone who has a smartphone. How does procrastination impact us? With access to social media, unlimited videos, and more content than we can physically comprehend, procrastination is something achievable for everybody and can have a serious detrimental effect on our day-to-day lives. For instance, there may be important chores like taking the bins out, having a shower, or brushing your teeth. To a lot of people, this seems like something trivial, but for someone who struggles with procrastination, these could be genuine challenges they face day-to-day. How does procrastination impact us? Continued. This, of course, can filter into our work lives. The games industry generally is built upon deadlines. These can vary from project milestones, content hand-ins, all the way to shipping. It's important that we stick to these deadlines, as getting behind can increase the pressure we face when working and can turn an enjoyable project into a mess no amount of Red Bull can fix. Chapter 2, Working from Home. How to avoid procrastinating at home. The trouble is, when compared to the office, avoiding procrastination at home can be challenging. There is no one way to avoid this, although there are small steps you can take to help prevent yourself. Apps to lock your phone, for example, Lock My Phone. These are apps that will lock your phone with a certain time frame or area that will still allow you to use your phone for emergency situations, but will prevent you from doom scrolling your favorite social media. Some apps have a feature where you need to pay to unlock your phone during set times, but I don't suggest enabling this, probably because you're all artists and we don't get paid enough. Give yourself a time of day where it's okay to procrastinate. If you find no concrete way of stopping yourself, then giving yourself scheduled time to do so will mean you get the relief you need while still having to perform the tasks you need to do. Make yourself accountable. The best way to do this is to simulate the office by sharing your screen with a friend or colleague, project permitting. That way, if you're getting away from your task, your chosen person can give you a positive nudge in the right direction and there's no hiding. If procrastination is something of a huge concern to you during work, let your line manager or colleague know this. Make sure you trust this person, as some individuals can unfortunately disregard you as lazy, but being open and honest with the people you work with every day can 1. Be a huge relief telling them, and 2. Be a catalyst to working out a better working environment for you. Maybe they can call you at a set time each day to have a catch-up, or potentially set work that excites you. What to do if you find yourself procrastinating? First, acknowledge that you're not alone. Procrastinating can cause you to feel guilt, anxiety, and low self-esteem. You may want to work really bad, but the modern-day internet is designed to keep your eyes glued to as much content as possible, so it's completely understandable that you're doing this. Take a moment to recalibrate and figure out what you were doing before you started watching the latest episode of Kitchen Nightmares. It can be helpful to write down a list of tasks you have for that day. However, don't feel bad if you don't complete these tasks. The more often you do this, the more often you can gauge what your work output is and when you work best. Drink or eat something. It can be easy to forget basic human needs when we're working in our home environment, and that tends to be food and drink. Don't force yourself to drink large amounts of water, as this can actually make you dehydrated. check out electrolyte imbalance. Yes, I found this out while procrastinating. Just make sure you have drinks and healthy snacks next to you so you can consume them when needed. Which brings me on to my specialty, foods and drinks to have at your desk. So very epic drinks to drink while working at home. First up is a protein milkshake. It contains high amounts of protein, which can help in the prevention of catabolic muscle breakdown, which can be common from being stuck at a desk all day. It also helps you get some epic gains if you're into the gym / fitness. Another very epic drink to drink is Pepsi Max or Coke Zero. Generally, I wouldn't recommend drinking soft drinks because they aren't healthy, but just like drugs, if you're going to do them correctly. This will also help prevent tooth decay, more so than the full-fat versions, and will be less likely to give you type 2 diabetes. Fucking next slide, thanks. Oh, yeah, caffeine will dehydrate you. Another epic drink to have is this holy grail, water. For all you real gamers, this is your best in-slot equipment. Get a nice big jug and treat yourself to some ice. Staying hydrated will help negate headaches, dry lips, and will aid with oxygen delivery too. Now some very epic snacks to eat while working at home. Nuts. Especially if you feel anxious while working sometimes, a small bowl of nuts is a great way to pick up food to keep your brain stimulated while you work. They're packed with protein and healthy fats to help you feel, apparently. Because we don't feel, we're all dead inside. Just make sure to eat them in moderation as they are very high calorie. Some more very epic snacks to eat are protein bars. Again, similar to the milkshake, you don't need to be a gym rat to enjoy these while working at home. I like to put them in the fridge or freezer so they take longer to eat, and a nice alternative is a standard chocolate bar. Try as many flavors as you'd like. Another very epic snack is the cheese and mayo sandwich. Mastering the art of cheese and mayo sandwich is not an easy feat, admittedly. But once you get the hang of it, prepare to ace any art test or deadline that you are dealt. The mystical properties of the American single encapsulate such taste sensation that Warburton's loaf provides a cozy bedding, and the mayonnaise is the piece de resistance, creating a creamy, undulating bite. How can you optimize your environment for productivity? If living with family or friends, set clear boundaries of when it's okay for them to contact you. This can also include boundaries like not entering your room or being quiet during meetings. Clear your desk of any junk, food wrappers, empty cans, your clay-fired model of your friend you made during the first year of university, anything that will get in the way of you and your setup. The more you clutter your surroundings, the more clutter your mind. How can you optimize your environment for productivity? Continued. Try to remove devices that easily distract you from your immediate area. Consider putting your phone in a drawer, iPads, smartwatches, and anything that gives you a reason not to use your keyboard. It can be useful for certain people to have fidget toys on their desk. You can buy specialty cubes and objects that have tactile buttons and textures that can help you concentrate while listening or talking during meetings. How can you optimize your environment for productivity? Continued. Find some music that you find stimulating. It could be chill lo-fi beats, heavy metal, classical music, whatever puts you in the right state of mind to work. In general, it's better to work in a cooler room than a warm room. PCs can get very hot and can make the room feel stuffy, so consider leaving the windows slightly ajar, which will help provide some fresh air into your setup. Try your best to use furniture that fits your needs. Some products may be listed as ergonomic, but everyone has different requirements depending on factors like height, country, and visual preferences. Chairs should be adjustable to suit your body, and your monitors should be placed in a way where your neck will not be strained. Tools and takeaways. Stuff to read. Eat That Frog: Get More of the Important Things Done Today by Brian Tracy. There's an old saying that if the first thing you do each morning is to eat a live frog, you probably have the satisfaction of knowing that it's probably the worst thing you'll do all day. Using Eat That Frog as a metaphor for tackling the most challenging task of your day, the one you are most likely to procrastinate on, but also probably the one that can have the greatest positive impact on your life. It's a really good book, has loads of tips, kind of ways of life. Kind of cringe, but yeah, good book anyway. Stuff to listen to. ADHD and How Anyone Can Improve Their Focus, Huberman Lab Podcast. For those who identify with some of the symptoms of ADHD, but to be honest, anyone that just procrastinates in general, Andrew Huberman is a professor of neurobiology at Stanford University School of Medicine. He discusses what ADHD is, the common myths, and the biology and psychology of it. The role of cell phones and technology in ADHD and ADHD-like challenges with focus are also discussed throughout. Both basic science and clinical scenarios, as well as applicable tools and resources, are covered. Some more stuff to read. Well, apparently you need to read this book. I swear there's something that... Oh, there it is. This is even more important though. Sandwich au fromage et à la mayonnaise by Ryan Thomason-Jones. I know there's some French speakers in chat. This is in English. Don't come at me with my pronunciation. Find out how Ryan crafted this beautiful sandwich inspired by the top chefs of the world. The article dives deep into his creation process, from his favorite ingredients to the presentation and unique style of Ryan's cooking. It can be found via the EXP website via articles. Special thanks to the Experience Points team, all the other speakers, Gilles for the second stream and Twitch, Big G for giving me a shout out on his Twitter, and all of you for coming to the talk. Some special no thanks. The piece of bread that cheated on me earlier, the piece of bread that made my piece of bread cheat on me, and ArtStation for removing my article, not epic, from you guys. Yeah, I mean, if they need to bring that back up. That was a treasure. Time for questions, because I definitely spent like 10 minutes speed running this presentation. I think I may have outdone myself and done 17 minutes instead. So if there are any questions, I will be happy to answer them. Food or actual working from home related, I'll answer them all. Thanks. Very good question. It was last year, and I donated to a charity that I don't remember the name of, and they basically said, "Wow, you're a really nice guy. We're going to give you a t-shirt." So that's how I got that. I mean, the trouble is just I encapsulate so many ideas that it really would take you such a long time. Plus, you sort of have to be reborn out of my mum, which, the logistics behind that, it's just not worth it, I think. But I mean, you can get close. You can get good at making cheese and mayo sandwiches. So, yeah. I mean, maybe death. Death is probably a close second, I think. But procrastination is actually a genuine problem. I think that it's kind of an unseen issue within the industry. I think there are so many projects that probably haven't met their peak because there are a lot of people that struggle with this. And especially, as I mentioned, a lot of people that have undiagnosed ADHD. I feel like we all kind of have a bit of us in that, but it's wrong to assume that everyone has ADHD. But I think that people should definitely reach out to any providers that they can. Basically, make peace with yourself and just be happy doing your work. And if you can go down a path of medicine to help you do that, then you definitely should. The bread's name. To be honest, I was only with her for like a day and then she went in the bin. So I'm not sure what her name was. I think the guy's name was Nonce or something. I don't know. I kicked him out of the house pretty quick as well. And they are definitely toast. Then you're winning at life, because that's quite a, I've never done that before. That's a pretty impressive skill. So congratulations. I mean, I'd love to. Kem has like money in the bank, so if he just wants to PayPal that to me, then I can do it on free XP, no problem. Right. Because ham and cheese is like, excuse my language, it's a basic bitch sandwich, okay? Every builder, every teacher, they whap into the office, they pull out the lunchbox, they get out the ham and cheese sandwich, right? It's not original. Okay, the cheese and mayo, it's so underrated. Once you get the ratios right and you bite into that cheese and mayo, there literally is not an experience like it. So that's why. Who asked that? No, that's an embarrassing question. But because I am here to answer questions, I will answer it for you. No, you can't. The only bread you can use is Warburton's. It comes in the orange packet. At the moment, it's Halloween, so they got some cool little pumpkins on it. That is the only bread that you can use when making a cheese and mayo sandwich. Thanks. I mean, if you manage to get through it, then I feel like you need no advice. Like, that's a feat in itself. So, yeah, I cannot offer any advice via that. But, yeah, thank you for watching anyway. I mean, it's a silly question. It's Warburton's. There are no other breads. I'd get out of here with the King's Mill. Get out of here with the Hovis. Right, Hovis is for nonces. No one likes it. So, yeah, Warburton's. I mean, I'll be honest. I've done a lot of research on ADHD, but I'm still going through the process of being diagnosed myself, so I can't really offer you any hacks. There are particular ways. If you're in the UK, I can offer more specific hacks if you like, of how you could possibly get help a bit quicker than the general route, which can take years. So if you are in the UK and you want advice about that, then feel free to reach out to me. But no real hacks, I would say. It's kind of something you have to learn to deal with over time. That's quite a com I mean, that tends to be the case, right? Especially if you're working from home, is that you tend to play games, which you might find relaxing. It might be what you spend your nights doing and what you enjoy, and then you also have to work on the same PC. So what I would suggest is, if you can at all, this is a stretch, but get a separate setup for both working and playing games, essentially. Or even put your setup in a different room to your bedroom, because your bedroom is tend it tends to be where you feel most rested. So if you have your PC in a separate room, then you'll feel like psychologically like going out to do your PC is where you want to do your work. So other than buying a different setup and putting that in a different room, there is no clear-cut way to do it. You kind of just have to push through, unfortunately. The mess. Okay. I mentioned the lock my phone for phone. I haven't actually looked at any on PC myself, only because I feel like we're in that day and age where there's probably not any software that can block you from viewing anything. Like if you're gonna procrastinate, you'll procrastinate no matter what. So other than locking your PC up, I don't know how many great options there are. But feel free to do your own research. I haven't myself. I know there are certain VPN softwares that will block you from going to certain sites, like social media sites. So that could be something you could look into. I think the biggest mindset tip is to separate the two parts of your life, which is working and just chilling and basically living life. I think something we don't do enough as artists in particular is just go outside, touch grass if you want. We're kind of at our PCs most of the time, and the trouble with that is we don't know any different. We don't know what relaxing is most of the time. We're constantly switched on, we're constantly looking at content. So to improve your mindset, I would say venture out the house, go and socialize with some people, travel, and then you'll find once you come back to your computer, you'll feel like kind of a mind reset. It's just go and have more experiences, and when you come back to work, you'll feel much better about it. I mean, there's some I won't say on microphone. You can think about that yourself. No. Meditation has proven to work for a lot of people. I used to meditate myself. It did actually work really well for me. Trouble is, I don't get up early enough in the morning. But yeah, give that a go. There's also, I think they've rebranded to Calm, the app now. That's a really good app. They have like meditation exercises on there. Just listening to another voice can really get you in the right mindset. So even audiobooks are really good as well. I mean, those are the trouble is those are the good times, right? Those are the good days where you feel like you want to work. For those days that you do that, I would just say, just be careful. Don't stay up incredibly late. The chances are you're going to anyway, so just make sure you have plenty of water, plenty of snacks to keep you going, and try and stay away from energy drinks as a rule. I can see the appeal, and I use them myself sometimes, but if you're going to use them constantly, you'll get not an addiction, but you'll feel compulsive. You'll want to have them all the time. So try and stay away from energy drinks. But when you have those moments of 20-hour work sprees, just embrace it. You won't get many of them. So I kind of just say, yeah, enjoy it basically.